Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Welcome back. We were discussing different types of charts to record the sequence of operations for any organization. We had discussed outline process chart and flow process chart. Now we are going to discuss swim lane chart, or it is also called swim lane diagram. So as the name implies, swim lane diagram or swim lane chart, so there are rows that resemble the lanes in a swimming competition or in a swimming pool. For example, these are the swim lanes that actually represent the different departments or different parties in a business. And we draw the process steps in the relevant lane. So the symbol for operation in swim lane diagrams is a rectangle. Like this, it's not a circle. Please keep in mind that for the rest of the charts that we are discussing, the symbol for operation is a circle. But for swim lane chart and one of the flow diagrams that we will later discuss, the symbol for operation is a rectangle. And you can notice other symbols as well. The arrow is the symbol for the flow of the material or information. And there is another symbol for the document or record, this symbol. So you can see credit form or order form, credit issue report. So these are this is the symbol for a form or document. So how this chart is drawn? So this is the symbol, just like other charts, some of the other charts and diagrams, for the start of a process as well as for the end of the process. So this oval like shape show the start of a process or end of a process. So the rest of the details are very simple to understand. So first you draw the initial activity. So that is in this case, this activity, that is the first activity that takes place. And arrow shows the first activity after this sales call, in this case, that is order entry. And as well as there is another activity that takes place, that is customer buys product. So now you can see that order entry takes place with the salespeople or sales department. And this customer buying the products is of course done by the customer, or the customer services department is responsible for this activity. Similarly, sales approved is also done in the sales department, and credit issue report is issued by the management or administrative department. And this is the symbol for decision making, just like other charts. So this is the symbol for decision making. And generally after the symbol, we have two options, either this thing happens or this happens. So after this decision, for example, either this activity takes place or this one. So generally after decision symbol, we have two options. So start of the activity, end of the activity. So there are two possibilities in this case regarding final activity, sales not approved or sales approved. And you can see the different activities taking place in different departments. So that is the benefit of this swim lane chart. So let's go through the description. A swim lane chart or cross-functional diagram is a type of flow chart that charts process from start to finish. So that is common with other charts as well. It divides the steps into categories to help distinguish which departments or employees are responsible for each set of actions. So that is something additional that other charts don't capture, but swim lane chart does capture. It makes responsibilities more clear than a regular flow chart. So we know which person or which department is responsible for certain activity. It can serve to highlight waste, redundancy, and inefficiency in a process. So we can see if some step is being repeated in two departments, it could be performed by one department. So we can. So this is the example that we have just discussed. So what is the benefit of using this chart? It can help department work together in a world where departments often don't understand what the other departments do. So it's a cross-functional chart. So each department can understand which activities are performed before some job is referred to their department, or what activities are done after they process a certain job or information. So this chart can help identify not just the bottlenecks in a process, but also which department is responsible for them. Like other charts, swim lane charts can communicate in clearer terms than a narrative description would. So that is a general benefit of all charts, that we can visually see the flow of a process instead of describing it in words. So this was swim lane chart or swim lane diagram. Very useful chart. If you have any questions, you can ask.